Sharks. They are one of the most mysterious clades of animals. Hardly any other creatures in our oceans are as fascinating to us as they are. However, despite sharks being one of the most diverse animal genera on the planet, with more than 400 different species, only a handful of them seem to be appreciated or even noticed by a broader public. So today I want to talk about one of the lesser known groups of sharks, sleeper sharks. More specifically about the Greenland shark found in the North Atlantic and Arctic Ocean and the Pacific sleeper shark found in the North Pacific. These two species are morphologically so similar that some scientists still take into consideration the possibility that they are all the same species. The only major difference between the two is their distinctive ranges. So what makes these sharks so special? First of all, they are one of the largest living species of sharks, with an average size of just under 4 meters or 13 feet and a speculated maximum size of 6 to 7 meters or 23 feet based on video evidence, they are comparable to the great white shark in size. That not many people have heard of them despite their huge size is mainly due to the fact that very little is known about them and they are very rarely observed, which in turn is due to their unique lifestyle. While most sharks live somewhat close to the surface, sleeper sharks instead spend most of their lives in the deep cold water near continental shelves and slopes. They are in fact one of the deepest diving fish. Rare sightings by cameras of underwater robots or oil rigs document this astonishing ability. Greenland sharks have been found in depths of up to 2,600 meters or 8,500 feet. Only the Portuguese dogfish, a different species of sleeper shark and the deepest living shark known, has been found deeper than that, at a depth of 3,600 meters or 12,000 feet. Adapted to living in frigid waters between minus 2 to 10 degrees Celsius, you can only find them close to the surface in places where the shallow water is cold enough for them, primarily in the Arctic. This makes them not only the biggest fish you can find there, but also the only shark that can tolerate Arctic temperatures year-round. As a result, they were long thought of as purely polar animals, but the continuous sightings of individuals in further south regions suggest that they are a lot more common than previously thought. To find out more about these understudied animals, researchers examined the contents of the stomachs of sharks accidentally caught by commercial fishermen. Originally, it was suspected that these sharks are mainly scavengers that feed primarily off carrion, but these new studies confirmed a much broader food spectrum. It seems sleeper sharks are opportunistic apex predators that will eat just about anything that comes across their path. Nearly every animal that shares a habitat with these sharks could be found in their stomachs. Most of it is fairly unspectacular, like a variety of small and medium-sized fish, crustaceans, octopuses, jellyfish, and gastropods. However, other findings baffled the researchers. Many Greenland sharks have been found with seemingly fresh meat of seals inside their stomachs, suggesting that they actively hunt them. Other notable finds include the remains of small whales, other sharks, dogs, horses, reindeer, and moose. Even the jawbone of a juvenile polar bear could be identified. A similar study done for Pacific sleeper sharks revealed countless squid beaks of colossal and giant squids in their stomachs, which suggests that they must be a big part of their regular diet. This makes sleeper sharks only the second animal known to science that hunts these squids for food, besides the sperm whale. Some researchers also suspect that Greenland sharks are responsible for a series of yearly seal killings off the coast of Nova Scotia. The strange phenomenon became commonplace in the recent years, as every year hundreds of mutilated seals are washed up on the shore of Sable Island. The wounds these bodies bear are extremely unusual. Most of them are long, clean-edged, corkscrew-like wounds that appear to have been made with a sharp instrument. But whether or not the Greenland shark is actually the corkscrew killer of Sable Island is still to this day not solved. Other potential suspects are killer whales and boat propellers. How sleeper sharks could ever catch living prey is also still a mystery. For one thing, they are absurdly slow, as the name might suggest. A satellite tagging study found that Greenland sharks are only cruising at a mere 1.1 km per hour through the ocean, roughly at the speed of a crawling baby. This makes them slower than any other shark. Pacific sleeper sharks aren't much faster either. And although both species are capable of quick bursts of speed in order to hunt, even then they are far too slow to catch a swimming seal or many of the other things they might want to eat. This led scientists to believe that these sharks are primarily ambush predators that use the darkness of the deep sea and their ability to glide silently through the ocean to sneak up on their prey. It is also suspected that they hunt seals while they are sleeping or carelessly poking their head through ice holes to breathe. Still, with no one yet directly observing them actively catching prey, the question how they hunt remains mostly unresolved. Also because many sleeper sharks appear to be almost blind, a huge majority of both Pacific sleeper sharks and Greenland sharks are colonized by a parasitic copepod that attaches itself to the front of the shark's eyes and eats its corneal tissue. It was hypothesized that the parasites might be bioluminescent, attracting prey for the shark and making it a mutualism rather than parasitism. However, there was never any scientific evidence for this theory, and it has been debunked multiple times by now. Overall, these parasites don't appear to affect these sharks too severely. Adapted to life in the deep sea, eyesight isn't mandatory for their survival. Instead, they likely rely on their other senses, particularly on their sense of smell, which is highly developed. Another topic we know very little about is their reproduction, as neither mating nor birth have been ever observed so far. However, we do know that Greenland sharks are ovoviviparous, like the great white and many other sharks. This means that they don't lay eggs, but instead give birth to live young, after the eggs have hatched inside the uterus. Additionally, new research from the University of Copenhagen revealed that they only reach sexual maturity at about age 150. This has likely to do with their very slow metabolism and the cold waters that they inhabit, which results in these sharks having a very slow growth rate of only between 0.5 to 1 cm per year. This was calculated through radiocarbon dating of certain metabolically inert proteins from the shark's eye lenses. These proteins are not renewed after being synthesized in the body when the shark was a pup, which allowed the researchers to estimate when the 28 individuals examined were born. Using this technique, they established that the largest shark, a 5-meter-long female, was between 270 and 512 years old, with the actual value most likely being somewhere in the middle. This means that the Greenland shark has the longest known lifespan of all vertebrate species. Unfortunately, the long interval between birth and sexual maturity might make them vulnerable to overfishing and environmental change. To what extent they are endangered and how the warming of our oceans is impacting these sharks is, however, not known, as no accurate global population numbers are available. Luckily, today there isn't any large-scale commercial fishery for them anymore. However, in the first half of the 20th century, Greenland shark was commercially fished for its liver. These were used for lamp and machine oil, and because of it, the sharks were killed in great numbers before synthetic alternatives were found and the demand fell in the 1960s. Today, there's only minor commercial fishery for them, mainly because their meat is poisonous for humans due to a high content of urea and other toxins. Eating this meat would make you seriously ill or possibly even kill you. Only in Iceland the shark is made edible through a month-long process of fermentation and air drying. The resulting dish, called hakarl, is a national dish of Iceland. Essentially rotten shark, the delicacy has made a name for itself outside of Iceland as the worst tasting food on earth. Due to its large size and its confirmed ability to at least temporarily survive in freshwater, some researchers have even wondered if sleeper sharks might be responsible for many of the sightings of the Loch Ness monster. But this is, of course, like so much about these sharks, just a theory. We will simply have to wait and see what researchers uncover about the coolest of all sharks in the years to come.